Hi, I'm Nick Saz, and today I am somewhere above the Dome in Fukuoka. Today we're speaking with a couple of the international players of the Hawks, and with us now, joining us is Carter Stewart. Hi, Carter.
How are you? How are you doing today?
I'm doing all right. All right, thank you for joining us. So, look, Carter, right off the top, you picked quite a year to start your career.
Yes, I did. I mean, especially going into this year, with everything that's going on now and everything that's going on last year, you know, it's definitely an interesting time for sure.
Congratulations. You pick up a win on your debut game in the spring season opener.
Oh, thank you. I mean, it was a new experience to pitch here. I know there wasn't any fans. You know, I'm sitting around here now, and it's weird without all the fans here, but it was a step up. I got a chance to throw, you know, with the big boys, and I did my job and got the win, which was definitely good.
Some of our readers, of course, know your story, which is a very unique story, how you ended up on the SoftBank Hawks. But can you give us a short version of that?
Yeah, I know it's definitely really different. But I finished high school and was a draft prospect, and I ended up getting drafted the eighth overall pick by the Braves, and just ended up signing due to medical concerns on their end, and obviously, you know, disagreements, but you know, it is what it is. I went to junior college for a year, or really just a semester, and played there. Played pretty well. Was thinking about getting drafted again. I got in contact with the team, and you know, we kind of got a deal done, and it just went from there. I got a deal done pretty fast. I came over here and started playing right thereafter.
And you have a very good connection with a former Hawks player, don't you?
Yes, they do. Mr. Matt Scarmeta.
He's from the same hometown, is that correct?
We live, 15 minutes apart, maybe, really close to each other. He was kind of my pitching coach slash mentor pretty much all high school and in college as well. And he's helped me with getting as better as a pitcher and, you know, everything around the baseball aspect. So he's been around for a long time. He's been a great guy to be in contact with.
And we're thankful here in Fukuoka that he brought you here.
Yeah, he's done a lot for me and my family and, you know, me as a baseball player and everything. So, you know, give a lot of thanks to him.
With this sort of lockdown, how are you coping?
You know, I'm getting better. Obviously, by myself, it can be a little lonely at times and stuff like that. But since I've gotten back to work, and because we did take, like, I think it was like ended up being like 10-day break from baseball just to try to make sure everybody's healthy and whatnot. When we came back, you know, it's a lot of trying to stay working every day. We're getting back in bullpens a little bit, but just getting here and working out and getting time away from the house and stuff like that. It's nice. And obviously, you know, being around the guys is good as well. Yeah, you have to keep your distance a little. But it's really nice to be here and still be able to practice and stuff and not just doing nothing at home, wondering when the season's going to start. It's just kind of getting our work in, which is, you know, it's definitely just right now is our time to get better.
But are you watching any TV series or catching up on some movies?
I'm asking my buddies what they're watching. You know, they're in the same situation as me. Yeah, anything I can find on Netflix right now, stuff like that, playing games, cooking, doing everything, you know, go out and take a walk if I can, you know, just depending on the day. But I try to stay active and keep my mind going and not just sitting there doing nothing.
Are you ordering in any food or do you cook for yourself?
Sometimes I order in sometimes. Just depends, you know, how I'm feeling. I've never been like really into cooking, but as I got here, I learned how to cook certain things. And, you know, I don't want to all the time, but I do, especially when, you know, I'm trying to eat healthy and stuff like that. I definitely cook for myself.
Now, how about Japanese food? Because you haven't been in Japan that long. Do you have any favorites?
I'm definitely curry rice has been my go so far. I really like it. The only thing I can compare it to is like chili in the States, but I didn't really know much about it before I came here and I started to eat it. I really like it.
Before the shutdown, did you have a chance to travel around Fukuoka or just outside the city?
I've been out a little bit. I'm really into golf, so I've been out in places, golf courses around Fukuoka. I've more or less around, you know, my part of around Takata and Fujisaki is kind of where I do a lot of my like travels and stuff. You know, I walk anywhere from around Hakata to, you know, around the airport area. I just kind of go, you know, see what there is to do.
Well, this the COVID-19 or coronavirus experience, the sort of lockdown, have you taken any lessons from this?
I'm definitely learning. I'm learning from a lot of foreigners and stuff and myself just to learn to get better by myself. And I don't need, and because right now, you know, you're not competing against anybody or anything. You're only doing this to get better for yourself and get ready for the season. And I think it's a big thing to do right now is to be able to learn from yourself and to get motivated yourself.
Do you have any favorite words or slogans in Japanese?
I like, you know, things that the guys say that I I kind of picked up on, but I don't think there's any like real favorite slogan yet. So like my Matsuda's little thing, but you know, I think as I learn more, I might try to come up with my own or something.
Any message to the Hawks fans?
I'm keeping at it, keeping coming here and trying to improve. And the way things ended going into this season, so far the way everything ended before, you know, the lockdown, you know, it was going really well. And I hope to pick right back up at it as the season comes around and as we get into it. You know, hopefully I pitch here in the Dome, but obviously I'll do my best no matter where I am. Maybe it be in the Neven team. But yeah, I mean, I'll just come out here and compete every day and try to get better than everyone else and, you know, prove my worth here.
Well, Carter, great talking to you.
Yeah, I appreciate you having me on. I appreciate it.
And we look forward to seeing you at the Dome.
All right, sounds good. I'll hopefully see you around.